where you're going with SoFlo, there's some people that don't want to hear fuck, shit, fuck. You know what I mean? There's a whole nother thing there where you've got a whole nother.
I agree with you. You know, and every show has its own format. Of course, fuck those people. because this is my dream radio station, which I've dreamed about since my first day inside a regular radio station, which we've all had the same thought. It's like, I really wish somebody would leave me the fuck alone and let me be myself on the radio show and then let people listen or not based on that and fuck everybody.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that's.
But
that's,
I certainly respect, know, for example, you know, we have a very strict formatting policy on By the Glass, for example, because he wants to market that
right
universally to everywhere. He wants each one of those shows to be able to be played by anywhere. And
but if somebody who listens to By the Glass and the show that comes on afterwards, say as a repeat of this show, and the first thing you do is go into a fuck shit, fuck pirate. Yeah. You know, that sponsor for By the Glass is going to be a little bit pissed off. They're going to say, well, you know what? Our Jesus listeners don't like that shit.
They have to understand that this platform is all-inclusive.
But they're not going to. Sponsors don't think that way.
That's
right. You have to kind of sometimes say, okay, you know what? I'm looking at this from that standpoint. And I believe me, and Hook knows this, we go back and forth about it all the time, about what we're going to replay on WDBS.
From the beginning, Boca will tell you, from the beginning... In the beginning, we tried to keep it very clean because we were hoping that possibly and we could shift gears at any minute and we could put a delay in here at any minute now that we would get picked up by terrestrial radio, and that's a laughable notion anymore in this town. There continues to be no avenue.
Well, and there won't be as long as it's as free as it is either. You know what I mean? No terrestrial radio station is going to pick this up if there's any chance that you're going to drop an F-bomb down the line and they can't,
they can't hit the delay. That is not the excuse. You know.
It's one of them.
No. None. There is no station in town that has general interest talk.
Well,
So before, there's excuse number
Rick
one.
Rick Sanchez.
Is not general interest. Yeah.
Jesus. Right, it's all sports radio or right wing politics,
and that's,
or
and that's
Haitian
fine
or Spanish.
If you like that. Not that there's anything wrong with that if that's what you like, but Jesus H. Christ, how about one single station that is all inclusive or generic, or at least offers a variety as opposed to this one topic radio station? You know, Neil used to talk about topical talk is dead, topical talk is over, and what did the industry do? It became super topical.
Right.
A one topic radio station. We would be shooting ourselves in the foot if we had a one topic radio show, which is what this one's sounding like right now. but these people have one topic radio stations.
No, absolutely. But see, I think that you have a different audience, okay? And it's like in the audience that came with SoFlo, when you first started doing SoFlo, and the people that followed you from the Neil Rogers show, a very specific, very liberal audience, okay? So, and just for instance, what happened at WIOD, okay? Instead of Nicole Sandler and this freak show, you know, and you and Boca and all on WIOD, they chose Rick Sanchez, who just this morning got picked up for Fox as a new Fox News contributor, by the way.
Of course!
Okay, and here you are, you know, going, and this guy gets the gig, and, you know, it's like, well, what did he do right, okay? What did he do right, or what did we do wrong?
I'll tell you what he did. He sucked Satan's cock.
He ran over somebody.
Sure. He's a white Cuban Republican, and the powers that be love that shit, and they believe that there is an element in the community, the communista crowd, there's like a handful of old Cuban ladies.
But it's a perfect example though, of what corporate radio wants. Okay, and
sure.
I mean, it's like, and
hey, look, we're finally on.
All right.
I don't know what happened.
Hey.
I switched off and switched back on. And
we got a Rick Sanchez block coming up.
Oh, please.
Oh, good.
Yes.
Good, Rick Sanchez.
Hey, Rick Sanchez, fuck you, man.
You got the one where he's singing?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
The one I don't have. I don't have the Rick Sanchez driving lessons.
I recently doubled my internet speed here at the studio in order to accommodate all this multicasting. Mm-hmm. That I'm doing over here. I was getting some latency problems, and that's all I need, man. I called Comcast.
So
I've got
doubled
super,
the speed.
I doubled my internet speed. I got a new modem, a new router. We're
nice.
Blazing in this studio, and the internet speed too.
So you have no issues now with video and audio. Everything.
The video is only subject like for example, you'll see that the video is very choppy right now, and there's a delay, and that has nothing to do with us. It has to do with the amount of speed that Ustream will allow us to have.
Right.
And once again, we tried live stream, and then there's that Tiki video. radio that Mitch tried.
Right.
I have experimented with all Tiki Live. I have experimented with all of them. The only one that I haven't experimented with yet, and I'm coming very soon, is that streaming live on YouTube thing.
What was the issue with Tiki Live?
Money. They wanted money, and it wasn't any better.
Really?
Yeah.
Break when you're ready.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do a break.
You want to hang on with us here, Captain?
Yeah, just for a minute. Sure, I'll stay with you.
All right.
Hang on, dude.
And we'll be back to 105, SoFloRadio.com.
Join the radio revolution. SoFloRadio.com.
It's the 1 to 2 hour.
Tell that Rick Sanchez to squat on this.
It's the Pete Dominic Radio Hour. Thursday night had a guest on Rick Sanchez. Let's listen in.
I think Jon Stewart's a bigot.
Oh my God, Rick Sanchez knows my name! I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control of the thing I like.
Actually, Mr. Sanchez was apparently angry at me and our program here for some of the fun that we had poked at his, quite frankly, extremely pokeable show. But he may have missed some of the point.
He can't relate to a guy like me. He can't relate to a guy whose dad worked all his life. He can't relate to somebody who grew up poor. I'm so happy that he grew up in a suburban, middle-class New Jersey home with everything that you could ever imagine.
Okay. I do occasionally have my issues with Rick Sanchez and his program, but he really nailed what it was like growing up in Central Jersey in the early 70s. The fortunate son of a single mother in the education field. Oh, I believe that's me right there. I believe that's from 1972. I believe that's me pedaling to the cotillion. Now, at this point, all is still well with the world. He said some things about me, but that's fine. And as I move to replace my Rob Roy with a rusty nail, that's right, I work all day in this decade, but when I'm home, it's the 40s. As I go to reach for that drink, Sanchez ups the ante.
I'm telling you that everybody who runs CNN is a lot like Stewart, and a lot of people who run all the other networks are a lot like Stewart. And to imply that somehow they, the people in this country who are Jewish, are an oppressed minority? Yeah.
Wow! All right! Now I'm angry. Because I realize I don't get back on the air until Monday. And there is no way this cat survives the weekend at CNN. It's one of those days when I'm thinking, why don't we tape on Fridays? Not that that would have helped, because by Friday afternoon,
Rick Sanchez of CNN got the boot.
The CNN anchor was fired after calling Stewart a bigot.
Now, I want to clarify something here. We weren't making fun of Rick Sanchez because of some slight to his ethnicity. It's just that we here see him as kind of a complex television character who is flawed but fascinating to watch every week. And we'd put this whole bit together to kind of demonstrate that point, and then they fire the guy. So doing the whole bit now just seems kind of mean. But you gotta have just a little taste of it, because it was so... Let me just give you a little bit of where we were going.
Saying that you should only do your best at the top of the art, but you got to give me something. Right? And I'm just saying, that's something.
What up with you?
What up?
Wikipedia is the best thing ever.
Social media makes our world circular.
Anyone in the world.
You've seen him on Channel 7 News. First as a 2-bit reporter. Now as a 2-bit anchor that wears more makeup than Tammy Faye Baker and Mary Kay combined. Rick Sanchez sings. Hear the dulcet tones of the man who brought you Crime Check, Rick Sanchez.
La Cucaracha,
Rick Sanchez. Rick Sanchez sings.
Give me a home with a buffalo robe and the deer.
Don't miss Rick Sanchez in his pasty face tour over Hialeah. It's one show you won't want to miss. Steak for a good one.
A one in a million.
Sanchez, he loves his audience.
I accept you as a precious gift from God.
Thank you. SoFloRadio.com, Byron Eggers, George Rodriguez, Boker Britt, right over there, and then special mystery guest lingering in the background. I should probably have, you know, I got masks and all kinds
of
right.
You're on camera
weird outfits. You can sing and dance and whatever other talents she has. Origami. Does she do origami? Macrame?
No.
Maybe?
No.
Oh, you know what? I was going to get you some headphones. Byron Eggers.
That's, you know, I'm fine. This is fine. It's fine. I actually like the overhead now.
Can you hear Captain Hook plenty?
Sure, I got him fine, yes.
You there, Steve?
Right here.
All right, cool. What a big gravelly voice the captain has over there.
Yeah, he does, man. He's the Live 365 thing, you know, I think we pretty much rung that out. It is what it is. I mean, it's like, and I cannot, you know, defend it beyond that it's convenient and it's there. And the issue is that, like I said, I don't have all 24 hours of SoFlo Radio like you do. So I need some place to put on my schlock that I want to run.
I absolutely believe in and encourage all of that stuff. I'm friends with, you know, Angel is the one that turned me on to the Sam broadcaster and gave me my first lesson in it. I've gone way beyond that since, but he owns and operates PSN Radio, the public service network. We are on.
Oh, I thought that's another piece of shit.
Almost all of our. You know, why would.
Sorry.
Start that again.
Just kidding. He doesn't like me anyway, fuck him.
Nobody likes you, Byron, because you're a bad person. Your daughter doesn't like you. She knows you're a bad person. You're a bad, evil.
Your own kid doesn't like you.
Heartbreaking, backstabbing bastard with a giant ego who thinks that other people should let you on their show to promote your show.
We go back to that. Okay, yeah, we forgot about that. Let's go back to the buy the glass thing. Okay,
buy the glass thing.
All right,
you are not qualified.
My argument. Okay, let me talk for a second. Right. Shut the fuck up. The deal is that what I'm trying to say is on that show. It's he's the one with the problem with the ego, thinking that by not having me on his show, that he's going to gain something from that. By me being on his show, he gets cross promotion from all of my listeners, okay?
Right.
From all the past radio shows that I've done, all the promotion that I've done.
I understand the value of cross promotion.
And he doesn't get that. And if I were on that show, then I would talk about him more. I talk about his show and I run his promo, but yet never once did he reciprocate. So guess what? You're fucked. You'll never be on my show again.
He runs your promos. We run, because I'm the producer of that show. I run your promos on that show.
Okay, so promo for
show.
Promo.
Promos, because that's the kind of format that Brett wants to have, and this is a medium for the host, of the host and for the host, and I'm not going to tell another host how to format their show. He wants the content to be very specific and very serious, and I don't blame
him. I'm perfectly capable of calling in on that show and telling him that I drink a certain kind of beer.
That doesn't qualify you. We don't have open phones on that show.
That's the problem.
No, it's not a problem. That's the format.
I don't care, really.
I know. You're being an asshole, which is, you know, you're good at one thing.
Thank you.
And also, Byron Eggers, great voice, asshole. He has a really
Hook agrees with that too.
Really,
he's known me a lot longer than you.
Really good.
Those days are kind of
radio pipes.
And I understand where you're coming from, George, coming from the WIOD and Neil Rogers and that sort of thing there. But when you go out to sell it, it's so hard to market it because I'll give you an example. I was in the DMV line, and I was talking to a guy that sells those little scooters, you know, moped-looking things, Vespa jobs. And I was talking to him about advertising when I was doing the putting together the This Week in Auto Racing. And I put on your show, and I showed him how easy it was to pull up the app on the telephone. And, in fact, I put the app on his phone while we were standing in line. And I happened to – it was noontime, and I happened to pull up your show, and it was shit, fuck, bap, bap, bap.
Yep.
And that just killed the deal.
I apologize.
Right?
And I agree with that. Well, and here's the thing, because we have partnerships. For example, I have a partnership with PSN. We exchange programming. I have a partnership with All Digital Radio. We exchange programming. Talk Radio X. We exchange programming. And now with WDBF, you guys have your programming. We'll exchange programming where we have commonality, where we have live avails available. And I think that that's great. That's wonderful. My confusion was, why, of all of the formats available, of all of the platforms available, why Live 365 when there seems to be so many reasons not to use it as both a listener and as a broadcaster? That was what I didn't understand. I'm scratching my head and I'm thinking, the only thing that would make sense of this to me is if somehow Byron has figured out how to get money from these people, mm-hmm. because so far they have figured out how to get money from me and from my listeners, but not the other way around.
Well, so the great opportunity with 365 is that pre-roll when you first hit the button. And that 1 minute pre-roll you can sell. Now, right now, you know, the number one internet radio show is Adam Carolla.
Yes.
All right. He gets 350,000 listeners every time. They're selling a 1 minute spot on his show for $8,000.
Right.
And so, but we're not, neither one of us are at that point right now. But down the road, I mean, it's worth something. That pre-roll, that 1 minute pre-roll.
Which could be run here on the main, you know, it's like, that's the thing. That pre-roll is a key thing because, and the problem is though, is every player has its own pre-roll. Every player has its own format. They won't run something like that.
Yep.
So trying to figure that out, you've got to put your commercials into the content, you know, into the show.
But you have to sell that.
Sure.
And charge.
Exactly. Certain Corolla has an eager sales staff. And
you got to remember too, and you're talking about 100,000, 300,000 listeners, man. It costs a lot of money for the bandwidth to be able to present that, whatever it is you're doing.
Sure.
You know, I mean, it's like, think of the dollars. I mean, it's like...
I do, all the time. Constantly. I'm thinking of dollars right now.
I mean, and that's really what the problem is. And I know that we're going to have to make a choice at some point on an alternative for WDBF to run the other programming on there, you know, to put it... Because, like you said, we're maxed out. I mean, it's like, not that that's any big deal, but no matter what I do at Live 365, it's going to be maxed out.
We are and we aren't. Now, if you go into Live 365 and you're not signed into an account that you already have there, okay, it'll come up and it'll make you want to buy the VIP thing to listen to the show. But if you're already logged in and you can stay logged in, and when you click on that, you're already logged in, you'll have no problem listening to anything that's on there.
No, but what he's saying is, like today, and it happened to me as well, I tried to listen to the JJ and Sam show on Live 365, and I couldn't do it the whole day, which is a good thing because that means we're maxed out.
No, it's not a good thing.
I was watching the numbers. At no time did we max out during that.
I tried logging on this morning as I do every – because what I do is when I get here in the morning, as I click on – now that I have the three buttons up there, which represent – the three platforms, I make sure that everything is playing on all of them.
You know what? You start with one listener. Okay, and then you multiply
and then
it
max out.
I mean, it's as simple as that.
It's a simple math thing. Why do I want to pay $30 a month for a low listener cap when I can pay $17 a month for 1,000? Just without
agreed. Then that's our next move. I mean, we're going to.
I like that deal better.
You know, sure. Yeah, we
I'm here. I'm here to share my knowledge and expertise.
I just wanted to establish myself first on Live 365, which is done now. I'm on SoFlo, established there. We're established on Live 365. And then I want to use my show to do what, you know, the promotion that I want to do for the other programming that I'm probably going to put on because, like I said, I'm limited to what I can do.
Hey, fuck George Norrie, by the way.
Yeah, you know, that's just something we're playing. I don't know.
That's something we did to
just to fill time.
I understand because I'm in the business of I want to fill it up with good live content. Also, I was just saying that to be funny. I actually think that because that's the kind of thing that is on PSN all the time is shows about things that don't exist.
Right.
Right, but, that out of sight. I mean, that out of sight show is very similar to George Norrie's show.
Yes, mm-hmm. And that's one of our exchange students. And I want to say he said that he was going to be calling in at some point today, Sir Daryl, which was one of our original exchange student when we started this many years ago. And he broadcasts from a secret location in Illinois somewhere. And he's been internet broadcasting, or whatever it is. He's been an internet broadcaster for I think 13, 15 years or something.
I got him beat.
He's up there and he's got a station with a lot of programming. We had a discussion about Live 365. I asked him just in passing when we were catching each other up. I said, "Have you used Live 365?" And he said, "Yeah, back in the beginning." And I said, "What's your you pay a lot for a low potential listening cap. It's not as valuable.
Well, you have to be a professional broadcaster. what they say as a professional broadcaster to make it and spend at least $400 a month.
Yeah.
And that's
right.
to have, I think, 500 potential.
And why would I give them $400 a month when I can have 1,000 listeners for $17 a month?
No, I understand it, but you don't get their marketing. You don't get the fact that you are on Live 365.
Indeed,
and
that
you,
is,
you know,
that's
it.
That's what I'm paying for
and
to be
gonna
on there.
If you're going to market yourself, which you do,
fact,
and we do, you know,
I'm going to change the station description to Live 365 Sucks Satan's Cock. And then the promo that I put in the player, I'm just going to put a series of promos in the player over and over again that that I'm going to have Boca make that say words to that effect. If you're listening to Live 365, you're a sucker. You're a chump. You should
just put that on your pre-roll.
Go to the banner on top of SoFloRadio.com right now and sign up for a radio loyalty account and get paid to listen. And you won't ever reach a listener cap. You won't ever have to be disappointed by trying to listen to your favorite radio show and having this thing come up and say, hey, if you want to listen to this show, you got to pay us, sucker.
I'll have to find the It Pays to Listen jingle.
Yes, it does. It pays to listen. I am a proud radio loyalty user. I've been using it for about a month and a half. I got 90,000 points already. At the end of the year, I'll have enough for an iPod, which it's like green stamps. It's like,
no, it's cool. I love that part of it.
It's next cool. to nothing, but that's more than nothing because all of the other players and all of the other platforms, they give you nothing or they charge you.
Well, the only thing bad about radio loyalty is it takes so long to load the stream when you first.
It's because it's a 128, and I do have a series of problems with them that I factor in. They broadcast at 128, all of their. They do things,
which is a waste if you're only broadcasting. At 64.
I agree because and right. I've written them emails and I'm going to write more. It's a little feedback. Your player is doesn't look good. It isn't pretty. For one thing, it doesn't instantly fire the way that Spark Radio does. I have to go to my presets and fire off a preset, but at least, you know, that's easy enough. It's a two-step process. And the other thing is the fact that, and I understand why they want to do 128. They want to have one lowest common denominator bit rate, and a lot of their internet radio stations broadcast music. So right. they want to have a good sounding stream for the people that are listening to music. But the problem that runs into that we've been plagued with since we began here is the buffering problem, the loading problem.
How does Spark Radio and all these other places handle the royalty situation, the ASCAP BMI?
Spark
thing.
Radio and all these other players, they're just players.
Doesn't matter. They're
still a direct service
the music to
irrelevant.
Go out there.
They're, that's,
no, it's not irrelevant.
It's a radio.
They got to pay for it
no.
somewhere.
No, when you
they,
buy a,
no, they don't have to. It's no. whoever originates it.
That's right. When you buy a radio, Byron,
but
you don't
it's
have
going
to pay.
Via them. That's like
Byron,
saying that you're a network station
a
and you don't have to be responsible for what's coming down the line.
Byron, it's a radio. GE doesn't have to pay royalties when they sell you a radio.
But
it's a radio.
Yes, but on and terrestrial.
It's a tuner.
But in internet radio, it's not like that. On a tuner, it's out in the open and it's free.
That's what Spark Radio is.
Spark Radio is not out there in
it
the open
is
and
a
free. It has one line in, and it's got to come out somewhere. Okay,
it's a tuner.
And they've got to be retransmitting
Dude.
That thing through a server
Spark
somewhere.
Radio.
So they're
Wonder,
responsible for the royalties.
Spark Radio, Wonder Radio, iTunes, U-Tunes.
They're all getting away
they're
with it
all,
for now, and it's
no,
going to come to an
Byron,
end. It will.
Byron,
it will.
You're
That's
under...
That's not the law. That's not
the
Steve.
Law will
Explain
change.
Explain to Byron that these are just radio players, and they have nothing to do with the content. They are just players.
That's not going to be the case.
They are just hosting the broadcast. You are the broadcast.
The server.
Byron, you are
okay, what about
misunderstanding.
Shoutcast?
You are monumental. That's
right,
a server.
How are they? They
That's
still
a
have-
server. Those are two different things. Shoutcast and,
okay,
and
so
Spark
then
Radio
are
not the same
are
thing.
Are not doing what
You're
Live
talking
365
about apples
does.
And hammers.
No, I'm saying that Live 365 is all messed up, but it's the only one that's doing it legally that's okay with the government as of now. They're the only one that's doing that. The rest of them are going to have to come on board or they're going to go
royalties.
Out of business.
I don't give. First of all, I don't give a flying fuck about music royalties. Second of all, fuck Live 365 being the only legal one. I know that. I've had, yeah,
I'm not
Alan.
Saying that in the sense that, you know, that this, to be cool. I'm just saying it as a fact.
No,
that that's what it is.
No,
and that's how
service.
It is right now. If you want to be completely legal and play music,
not,
okay,
you
but
the service they
but they
offer,
all everybody but, does, though. Maybe you don't, and I don't. I play most of my stuff as reggae, and I get away with it because they're all private labels, and I have permission to do it. But if I were on there playing rock and roll music every day, okay, you could not have the stream that you have because you just couldn't do it. And you couldn't do it on SoFlo. If somebody really wants to be a dick out there, they can. And they could say, you know what? I heard George play, you know, Too many seconds of such and such song.
Do it. It's the responsibility of the broadcaster.
That's right.
I think ultimately.
Ultimately, yeah. It's the responsibility of the broadcaster.
And it will, but the problem will be is that it won't only be the responsibility of the broadcaster. It will be the server's problem, just like it will be the transmitter's problem.
Okay.
The person that owns the station.
With regards to servers, there are three. And you know that because when you open up Sam asks you which server do you want to encode on? Shoutcast, Icecast, or Live 365?
Right.
Those are the servers, and those are the ones that, according to you, and I'm not disagreeing
with
that.
Only one out of those pays royalties and covers you as far as
one of them.
That part.
One of them collects royalties on your behalf and pays the royalties on your behalf, and that's Live 365.
Right.
The other ones, first of all, Radio Loyalty says that they have the royalties covers. Whether they do or whether they don't, I don't know, but that's part of their little, when you read the things, and I read all my shit, they go, royalties are included, we prepay royalties based on our ad revenue, so don't worry about that, you can play the fuck out of music. That's Radio Loyalty. And Vozcast, they stay out of it completely. They may or may not be breaking the law, they may or may not be called on the carpet for being a conduit for people that are playing copywritten music.
They're trying to now.
But with regards to all of the players and all of these apps, they're merely radios. They merely pick up a stream, and they have nothing to do with content, and nor can they be held liable. For example, Wonder Radio, one of our first, it's on a lot of our original advertising of the little flyers that we put out. Listen on Wonder Radio because they were one of the first radio apps that was really slick and good looking.
They exist anymore?
Yes, they are, and I use them. They're on my thing. We look really nice, and they're very, very easy to use also. I put them in the category, the good category. They're a good radio player, Wonder Radio, and they don't bombard you with a whole bunch of pop-up ads and things. They continue to be a good player, easy to find you or us on there. You dial up SoFlo Radio, boom, they're right there. You search under local radio stations using the Wonder Radio, and boom, there's SoFlo Radio. It's fine, but they're still just a player. They still just relay streams. They have nothing to do with the content. Nobody's going to put any of the players out of business, but with regards to the platforms, yeah, there may be some big issue in the future, and you know what? And if it becomes an issue, then we'll switch. We'll drop this and go to that one. Whatever.
Well, the only issue that will happen is that the internet law is going to be different than what terrestrial radio law is as far as, you know, ASCAP, BMI, and royalties. And they still don't even know what to do with it. The other issue is, too, is that you talk about internet radio and the fact that you can curse now and you can say whatever you want. You know, that's only a matter of Congress or the government deciding that they want to encompass internet underneath the same guise as terrestrial radio, and it can all come to an end and just instantly. They can say, you know what, we have decided now we want you to be, and we have the switch here in the White House.
They tried that a year ago.
There's a lot going on.
No, and they're
going
to keep trying it, too. They're not going to stop until they can try to police it.
They're going
to
keep trying.
There's support for that, though, right?
They want the Chinese firewall. They want the same firewall that they have in China, and it's going to be very difficult, if not impossible, to achieve because all of the people, like I had this discussion with Eric, rest in peace. It's like, hey, what's going to happen if they do this thing? It's like we move our servers to Bimini, bang. We move our servers to Sweden, bang.
Well, there's always a way around it. There's pirate radio still, so people get around it somehow.
And so we'll be pirate internet radio. I don't give a rat's.
And that could happen. That could happen. There may be something like that, you know, and it really is. There actually is because a lot of the places are really doing pirate internet.
Well, how are they going to license you to broadcast online?
Well, that could be easy. They could,
by what?
Well,
an engineering license?
I'll take the application and slather Fumunda cheese on it and mail it back to
them. Easier than terrestrial radio to keep track of what's going on the web because everything is via IP address. It's so, you know, whereas in terrestrial radio,
I can install software right now that will make my IP address whatever the fuck I want it to. I can have my IP address originating out of fuck it Thailand if I want to.
Maybe we'll get grandfathered in.
Now that's
we already got
like
our
that.
Tickets, you know.
Yeah, there are
you got your ticket, right?
Oh yeah.
Your worthless ticket?
$60. There's a service.
I have a bunch of them.
You got the first class?
Oh, I have an advanced class.
I have a first class
ham radio license.
I have a first class. I just had to take a test, baby.
I think I left
there's
it here.
There's a company that for $60 a month, they will not just mask your IP address, but you can decide what city, what town, what hamlet.
No, but they could arrest them and put them out of business.
You know what?
And, you know, I mean, it's like, trust me, if the government wants to make the internet totally controlled and start tracking people, they can do it, okay?
I know they can.
I just think that you want to be careful about trying to be so pirate radio-esque and to claim that, oh, we can do anything we want.
I can do anything I want.
because that's what shuts down pirate radio.
I can do anything I want.
They usually leave pirate radio alone until they start cursing.
George Norrie and Michelle Schacht. I mean, just fuck them all.
Or claiming that, like, the you start defacing people and doing those kind of things.
That's a thing that I'm all when I give people like new recruits to internet broadcasting, I give them the lectures. You can say almost everything you want. You still can't slander. Slander is independent of the vehicle. Slander has to do with the message, not how you deliver it. And the owner of the vehicle is as liable as the author. And so I'm very careful about lecturing people. If you slander people, that's it. You'll slander people once on this platform, and that's it. There will be no second chances. I will distance myself from you faster than anything.
Now, you can't slander a public figure, though.
You can't slander, period. Slander has a definition.
No, but can you slander a public figure?
You cannot slander
Rick Sanchez.
You cannot slander a public figure.
What's the difference between slander and talking to,
you cannot criticism is not
you cannot
slander,
make
right?
a statement of fact that is not a fact. For example, when I say that I saw Rick Sanchez dance with the devil in the pale moonlight, I will swear on a stack of Bibles that I saw that.
Right.
Sue me, Rick Sanchez. Please sue me. I saw Rick Sanchez suck Satan's cock. Sue me, Rick Sanchez, please.
But a statement so ridiculous as that, no one's going to see that as an actionable.
Right. Well, yeah.
I'll testify in court that I saw Rick Sanchez.
That you've taken something.
He took it up the ass from Satan, and then he turned around and licked it clean. I saw it.
And Sanchez dated me, I'm not going to say that on the air.
Right.
Well, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
The news has just broke.
He already had a homosexual relationship with Neil, and he wanted one with me too.
Brittany Bryant. I remember
that. Will get you in trouble, Richard.
Rick Sanchez worships Satan,
and he said that. You know when he said that? He was at a golf thing. He was being interviewed by Jim Mandich live on the air when he said that about that relationship with Neil Rogers. I'll never forget. I heard it live on a Saturday.
And he offered to drive me home. I took a cab. I said, no thanks.
Man, we're learning a lot here today.
Yes, we are.
All right, you guys, I'm going to break away.
We're going to take a break also. Nice having you on, Captain.
See you, buddy.
All right. Peace out. 28 till 2, SoFloRadio.com.
Longer, firmer, and fully packed with flavor. SoFloRadio.com. Put a team of professional consultants behind your home or business computer with Key Information Solutions, providing solutions to your internet and computing needs while keeping you on the cutting edge of technology. Preventative maintenance and networking support, hardware and custom-built computers. Let Key Information Solutions be your personal tech staff for your home or office with affordable hourly, monthly, or annual rates to fit anyone's budget. Call Key Information Solutions now, 954-973-3374. That's 954-973-3374. Or visit keyinformation.com.
Hi, this is George. You know, trying to get laid all day makes me hungry, so I go to Power Smoothie in Aventura and get the healthiest wraps and most delicious smoothies ever made. I mean, really. The smoothies are so insanely delicious, they're orgasmic. The staff is friendly there and cute. The food is healthy and real, not processed. This is not fast food. It's good food served fast. And they love me there. They even let me create my own smoothie, the Malted Jorge. Go in and ask for one. They're in the Promenade Shops right off of US 1 in Aventura. Or call them at 305-792-5338. You can also visit them online at powersmoothieaventura.com.
By the Glass.
By the Glass is a show about beverage culture.
Brad Hubbard.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the dots on how everything works together. It's really all about how we enjoy things, how we enjoy life, and how beverages play a big part in that. I'm going to bring in people that are going to display their aspect of the culture. I'm going to bring in people that are going to show you different products. We're going to look at places where people go to consume these beverages and how they all interact. Things are built around the actual beverage itself.
By the Glass. Thursdays from 6 to 7. Only on SoFlo Radio. SoFloRadio.com.
SoFloRadio.com invites you to call. It's free and it's easy. All you have to do is pick up the phone and dial 954-990-0036. That's 954-990-0036. SoFloRadio.com.
There's something wrong with our PD. Our program director is upset. I asked him.
Don't give. I mean, I fired it off while you were in the bathroom.
The hamsters.
Yeah, we got a real problem with this computer. Well, I'm glad I wasn't at the helm because he'd be ripping me, man. He'd be like,
it blew through to break okay, then goes into the.
And then it stops. And I'm sure it's a setting thing that we have to. Just like everything else. So that's the thing about it. It's an obsolete piece of software, but there's still nothing else like it. 954-99-0036. We're here with Byron, who is you're going to be saying some goodbyes.
Yes, we are. We're going to be saying goodbye here.
Well, I have a gift for you.
Oh, that's so nice. Oh, here. Yes, we're going to talk
there's,
about
there are the, strings attached. Yeah. Well, I mean, I.
Oh, that.
Here
oh,
at Sofa. I mean, oh, I don't know. Do you only wear bandanas?
No. I love hats. Are you
these,
kidding me?
These,
I wear them right over
these
my
hats bandana. And our station swag. Not a freebie. I paid top dollar
they're
for
nice.
It's not Velcro.
I love it.
All right, and it's very, very nice embroidery. You know, and here are the strings attached, and it's for team members. It's for SoFlow Radio team members. And all I want you to do is like a couple things. I really encourage people to post on the SoFlow Radio Facebook page to promote their upcoming shows. But
I don't
obviously
do that.
What's that?
I don't do that.
You do that, but then you post these long, self-inflating, overly descriptive. It's like a book
right.
on there,
don't
and
like
and
that.
What and
I
and
ramble.
You,
I am not good
you
at
ramble
it.
Ramble, and it's a little bit too frequently. And I don't want the post on the SoFlow Radio to become in the minds of our Facebook friends like spam. Like here's another
right.
I don't want it to be a
you
spam.
Just want direct
vehicle.
To the
I
point.
Want people to say like you know
tune
maybe
in
maybe in the morning a couple times a
show.
Day. Tune in tonight. Blah blah blah. And then right before the show, hey, tonight we're gonna have these many guests and like the posts that you see other people doing, like a little blurb, a little paragraph, like a sentence or three or something like that. And the other thing is, I'm all for everyone having their own internet radio station, and I understand that WDBF is its own concept and you know, with a potty language and everything like that. But obviously, it is in our mutual interest, not just mine, but all of the other radio shows, to promote SoFlow Radio. People go to SoFlow Radio, they see, you know, all big and pretty, all of the shlogos right there for your show, the powwow, etc.
Simple
so
concept. You promote me, I promote you.
Right. So stop posting links to that foul and unctuous Live 365 on SoFlow Radio, because I don't want to promote Live 365. I want it to go back the other way. I'm on Live 365 specifically and only to get people to listen to SoFlowRadio.com.
Now, I thought that I was not doing that. I thought when I was
the
posting
last post
on
that you
SoFlow,
did.
Like okay.
five links to WDBF on Live 365 links on there. So you're using the SoFlow Radio Facebook page to advertise for a internet radio station that is not SoFlow Radio.
Right.
How about when you
see that throws
you have
off
a WDBF when you have a WDBF Facebook page, I'm gonna spam it with posts about SoFlow Radio, and I'm specifically gonna say if you listen to Live 365, you're gonna get ass cancer. Live 365 will give you AIDS if you use it,
and not the diet candy.
I hate Live 365. I would like you to use because you have a show and a nice pretty image right there on SoFlowRadio.com. When people when you post the link to SoFlowRadio.com and people go, oh, there it is, there's Byron, and then they see all these other wonderful shows that they have all nice and pretty right there. I designed the website this way because other people said, no, you should have a list. And it's like, no, if I have a list and the people don't see what's at the bottom, I designed the webpage so that they would get a snapshot of all of the shows that are on, all there nice and pretty, including yours, and then right next to yours they see the powwow. It doesn't benefit the other shows on the station if you post links to WDBF, because then they go to WDBF and then they don't see all of the other shows.
I think that's kind of been my little rip at other people for not cross-promoting back.
Well, that's...
You know, it's like it's been kind of
like... You're using collective punishment.
Right,
then,
which works for me.
No, well, it doesn't work for the collective. And I'm not going to tell other people what to do on their show. I am going to tell other people what to do on the SoFlow Radio Facebook page.
Right, the
and
overall.
I would like people to understand that their show is on SoFlow Radio. Please post to listen to the Byron Eggers show on SoFlow Radio and create a WDBF Facebook page and promote the programs that you have on WDBF on that.
Right, but the other
but please don't use the SoFlo Radio Facebook page to siphon our audience, because I want them to listen on SoFlo Radio, and I want them to go to the SoFlo Radio right. site so that they can see all of these other shows that are compensating me to be on this station.
Now, and there lies the problem of when we made the changeover and I stopped rebroadcasting SoFlo Radio on my Live 365 page.
Right.
You know what I mean? We should have kept it that way.
We should have. We should have.
We go back in retrospect.
I would probably not hate Live 365 if that were the case. However, I would like to have it, because you want separate programming, different programs.
We still could have done that. It just could have been done differently
by
having it that way.
I want the Live 365
stream to be SoFlo Radio.
Stream to be all of the SoFlo Radio programs, of course.
Right.
And I have, and PSN, I don't know. I don't think they have a Live 365 thing, but you know, I carry some of their programming. We carry some.
And at the time too, when I first started doing that, there was another reason why there were some crappy shows on here that I didn't want to even be part of.
I understand. Well, some people might say the same thing about yours.
Yeah. Well, I'm an actual broadcaster.
Okay.
As opposed to non-broadcasting people that
that's
been
not
on.
That's not relevant.
That's all.
I don't
want to be affiliated with
them. That was all. It was just a simple thing like that, you know?
There are shows where the format allows for random stream of consciousness and guests and miscellaneous programming, and there are shows that are very formatted.
No, they just aren't good shows.
Well, I disagree with that. See, I think the Nicole Sandler show is very good, but there's
no
reason.
I agree with you. No, I think Nicole's great.
She doesn't have... She has guests on that are specific to, which is, you know, she has big name politicians. She, you know, she has Alan Grayson on. She has all these people on, all these people that
she doesn't cross promote at all.
Have an excuse? No, she doesn't. And then she's another one with her own vehicle also.
Mm-hmm. Well, we went on the flagships. Were
great example.
Joe, us, and then you. So which one of those didn't you like?
And I told her I had a discussion with Nicole. Like
she was fatter.
She gave me a bunch of promos for her show, but they don't mention SoFlo.
Right.
And I said,
I told her,
I'm not going to play them. I would like, go ahead and promote Talk Radio 1 and RadioOrNot.com, but I want our promos to have a consistent ending because we use them as rejoins. So the promos, for the sake of formatics, correct sound, and so that the board operator can take a cue off of it, it needs to end with SoFloRadio.com, blah, blah, blah. Say, listen to the Nicole Sandler show on Talk Radio 1, RadioOrNot.com, and the home of the South Florida Radio Network, SoFloRadio.com, and that needs to be the last thing said so that we can then go back into programming from there.
See, and I totally agree with you there. It's like that is kind of what needs to be solidified and talked about, like we're doing right now. You know, I'm writing down notes of things, I'm not going to do this anymore, I won't do this anymore.
The content
and I get it.
In between the shows, my show, and on the promotional vehicles like the SoFlo Radio Facebook site. Those are mine, and I control that content. But within the confines of an individual's radio show, they own that time.
Right.
And I am respectful, worshipful of that show host's ability to define what that show sounds like during their time slot.
So when I'm done doing my show at 9 o'clock on Wednesday night, which I'm going to get a plug in for myself.
Please do.
Wednesday night, 7 to 9, it's the Eggman and Hook show, and that was Captain Hook had just called up. And
that's
then
right.
Saturday nights,
great
7
voice.
To 9.
Gravelly voice. That's a whiskey and cigarettes voice on the Captain
Hook. Yeah, a lot of whiskey, a lot of cigarettes.
Right. Reminiscent of Eric a little bit.
Yeah.
Whoa, no, I didn't think.
And 7 to 9 is Reggae Recipe, which is a show that I do with H Love, and it's reggae music. And by the way, I believe tomorrow night we're going to have the Fab Five on. So if you want
to
take a look.
And you can listen to those
Dave
shows.
Dave Clark Five? Really?
Fab Five.
Oh. You can listen to those Fabulous shows on SoFloRadio.com with a multitude of choices, Live 365 among them. However, I recommend Radio Loyalty, where you get paid to listen.
Yeah, and it's and on Live 365 at that time, it's on two different places on Live 365, which is kind of redundant. But it is,
but nevertheless, it's crossover. For example, right now we are on SoFloRadio.com. We are on PSNRadio.com as well.
Oh, we're on PSN?
We are. This is part of the programming exchange. And then very soon when I get the deal solidified with Daryl, depending on our mutual schedules, where availabilities allow, we will have some of our shows on Daryl's station also. It might, depending on what his schedule is like, it might be your show also. So you might be simulcast on SoFloRadio.com, WDBF.com, PSNRadio.com, and AllDigitalRadio.com. Potentially, again, I can't make any promises. It really depends on, Daryl and I are going to have a virtual, you know, let's sit here on Skype one of these days and go through hour by hour to see when live programming is available based on the the avails that are available on each other's network. Now, same way that I do with PSN.
Yeah, and that'll be interesting to put that all together.
And we can do that same thing with WDBF as you get new original programming on there that is suited to the format of that radio station, meaning no potty talk.
Yeah, and I don't even know where I'm going with all that. You know what I mean? It's like it's just there's different shows, and I have a bunch of material from being in terrestrial radio for other shows. I have some really great old shows that no one has. They don't exist. I've got a show by called The Great Sounds by Ray Otis, and he was a great voice out of Chicago. He's still alive. And I have the Skitch Henderson show.
Skitch Henderson?
Skitch Henderson
wow,
show.
Wow, that goes
back. And you will
back.
Not find that anywhere. He was the original Tonight Show bandleader before Doc Severinsen.
Yeah, that's right.
And it was only on down here on 1420. And it was only, you know, it was very rare. They were supposed to have been thrown away, all the tapes. You know, back in those days, they sent out in record albums, and they were supposed to be thrown away. And I have 137 of those shows. They're
wow.
2 hours apiece. And I've just got some amazing stuff that I want to do. That's what I want to originally do with WDBF, is kind of go back to a big band kind of a format.
That's,
and be
that's
completely
great.
Separate from what SoFlo is. In other words, a completely separate deal.
It's just
kind of in the interim phase of getting
like,
it there.
I like all those ideas.
Yeah.
Considering the demo in that area of the signal, it's a good idea.
Yeah.
I mean, you do reach Century there. You reach
Are you
King's
implying
Burnt.
That there's a terrestrial signal somewhere broadcasting my signal?
I'm guessing. Even if it's like a quarter watt, like QAM is.
Yeah, I defy a terrestrial radio station to relay this thing.
Well, you know, that would be interesting because I've had talks with terrestrial radio stations about that, and I couldn't get anywhere. You know, it's like as soon as I would have them listen to the programming, you know, it was kind of like, well, you know, we really can't do that. You know, it's like because of who it is and what it is. And a lot of it was a perfect example of the Rick Sanchez thing, you know, over the Nicole and George and Boca show, you know, they're just not going to do it. And they're not. They're afraid of this kind of real free-form radio.
It was fun to do it, but I had no aspirations.
I got some feedback from inside the building. I might as well say it on the air. And it's what we suspected. I had two independent sources, like people that don't interact with each other. But you know how I've been in radio in here in this town for 100 years, so I know a lot of people, including a lot of people in that building. They hate Nicole and that company because of her politics. They hate her hard. Because of her politics. And if you think that you're, like, for example, I was looking for some programming because we're going to carry Daryl from 1 to 3. I was looking for 12 to 1 options. And Radio Dan's station, Talk Radio X, has a 12 to 1 show. And I listened to it within 10 minutes. He was kissing Alan West's ass, and that. And like, really, you gotta listen to this guy. He's very inspiring. You're
Radio
but
Dan.
But he talks like this.
Yeah.
He talks like this. He sounds so gay. He sounds so gay. And I needed to hear no more. It's like if you're kissing Alan West's ass. All right, a failure if ever there was one. A bad person. A person that you know with the firing of the gun. You know, a fake macho man.
It's a prevailing problem with internet-based broadcasting for any iPod podcasting. You can't just roll out of bed and say, I'm going to be a broadcaster today, because
so
I equate that to Ramsey.
That guy would have to pay me a lot of money to be on the station.
But you know, the problem is on both sides of the spectrum there. You know, it's kind of like what you do, you know, on your show. You know, it's like you come across, you know, very liberal and just hating anything to do with anything, you know, what you would say is politically to the right. And then the other side, you know, comes across the other way. The problem is that, and that's the way I see it, is you can't let that affect your broadcasting. You know what I mean?
What made my decision?
It's not that, but see, that's personal. You know what I mean? It's something you don't like. You're this personal. It's like,
you give this guy a listen,
he'd
be like,
I don't like Nicole Sandler because of her politics, when I know she's a great broadcaster.
I don't want
to. You got to put that aside.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And that's the key thing, because I think Boca on the air is the best. I love your show. I hate your politics.
At Clear Channel,
I love your show.
They will not, the story that I got from the two people is like you know,
see, they
I don't
can't
care.
Get around
I don't care
that.
What kind of glad handing they do. They have a political agenda, And they're not going to let someone on their air that has a diametrically opposed philosophy.
In a way, you have a political agenda. It's a very liberal political agenda.
Not really. I don't like that word. I'm an anarchist, first of all. I get into arguments with Boca Nicole.
The lessons we learned were that you have to have broader appeal, despite your politics.
Exactly.
At least it's listenable. I don't have a problem whether you agree or not.
With you or the captain and the political talk that you do, because you guys sound good. This whiny little
nebbish.
This whiny little nebbish. This whiny little nebbish kissing out. It's like, get out of here.
Give me an example. Mandage. I can't stand sports radio, but he was fun to listen to.
It was a great. That's a great example. Jim Mandich, great example of people listening, liberal and conservative. And everybody knew Jim Mandich's personal politics were very conservative.
Didn't matter.
You know, it didn't matter
he was fun to listen to. Sure.
And I think Neil had that. Neil was listened to by a lot of closet conservatives listened to Neil and wouldn't miss it for the world. They loved it.
Because it was fun. Because despite your idealisms are, who cares?
And I think
I just want to get through today.
And I think that's kind of the focus where we miss that. And it's very difficult to get that across because you have in this whole world right now, you've got Fox News, you got MSNBC, you got freaking Bill O'Reilly, and you got what's the guy on that comes on after Bill or before Bill?
I wouldn't know.
He's gone. Ed
No, not Ed Schultz. He doesn't even count. The guy's been on forever over there.
Chris
Matthews. Perfect example. And to me, those are the two extremes. Now, I watch both those shows because I think a pretty fair guy when it comes to listening to what's going on. Because I want to know both sides. I watch Bill. I watch Chris every single night if I can. It gives me both sides of what's going on. Now, but the problem is that most people either hate Bill or they hate Chris. And then you're trying to get like this, you know, it's like, and I think we've kind of lost the fact that they're both excellent broadcasters. Mm. I just believe that. You're going to tell me that Bill O'Reilly's not an excellent broadcaster.
He's got a good voice, but
he's
been in broadcasting all his life as opposed to Matthews, who wasn't.
Well, yeah, but they're, and I don't even think Chris Matthews is really that great of a broadcaster.
He's just been on the air a very long time.
But it is one of those things. Right? But I think the entertaining part is the key part. And try to keep out the
I'm Chris Matthews. Welcome to Hot
Pile. Let me finish. Why is he on twice?
I don't know.
They repeat it.
Chris Matthews played Hot Pop.
In prime time, they repeat it. That's just like at midnight or whatever, they switch over to some prison show.
They love the prison bitch stuff. Did you hear my show on that? I had some fun with them.
When do I talk?
After I finish, I'll let you know.
Go ahead.
The following is a paid commercial for Chris Matthews. Not yet.
All right, we're going to get out of here.
Let's take a break so that I can walk you out, say my goodbyes. Thank you so much for visiting the studio. Do this more often.
Thanks, everybody.
I've been evolving the studio. It is set up so that we can do Skype, and you could maybe run the spots out of your studio. We'll do this every once in a while.
Yeah, I'd love to do
it. Crosh-Mullis. And I never got a chance to do my stick figure presentation of versus consumer side economics. So we'll just save that for the next time.
Yeah.
It certainly was a two-way thing. I had it all worked out. A little village, a Walnut Grove analogy, two brothers, Bill and Bob. It was wonderful. And I wanted to get you to tell me, you know, what you think would be the best course of action and which philosophy should be encouraged by society.
I'm confused at this point because, you know, I voted for Obama and I'm sorry I did.
Well, let's not even get into that.
I'm
join the club because
I'm not
we
as confused as you are, though, Boca.
But for different reasons. What he's doing is he's become more of a tool of the right wing than anyone ever thought.
I agree with you. And it's
like assassinating American citizens with drones? God damn.
No.
By the way, our address here is.
Yeah, really. There's probably one out there flying around right now.
I should
now.
Give them my home address where my wife is right now. But she's already got drones already in the house while I'm gone, so it's all right. Thank you so much for visiting the studio.
All right, guys.
Your lovely daughter. You don't even worry about that. It attacks people all the time. The little pull up bar. I have it specifically to take the heads off of tall people. I hate tall people. And Live 365. Byron, it's been a lot of fun.
All right, guys.
Shout out to Captain Hook, and we'll be back on SoFloRadio.com.
Bye.
Do you know who we are?
SoFloRadio.com.
We now listen to Urban Radio.
Your mom is so fat when she was a kid, she could only play C.
Yeah, all right, check it out. Your mom is so old, she remembers when Burger King was a prince.
All right, check it out. Your mama's crib is so small, I stepped on a cigarette and the bitch said, who turned off the heat?
Yo, all right, check it out. Your mama's got one leg shorter than the other, so everybody calls her Eileen.
Oh my God!
Your mama's so yabonic, she thought a paramedic was two doctors.
Jesus Christ!
Yeah, well, your daddy's so stupid.
What?
The Nicole Sandler Show, weekday mornings at 10 on the South Florida Radio Network. Put a team of professional consultants behind your home or business computer with Key Information Solutions, providing solutions to your internet and computing needs while keeping you on the cutting edge of technology, preventative maintenance and networking support, hardware and custom-built computers. Let Key Information Solutions be your personal tech staff for your home or office with affordable hourly, monthly, or annual rates to fit anyone's budget. Call Key Information Solutions now, 954-973-3374. That's 954-973-3374. Or visit keyinformation.com.
To reach the George Rodriguez Show, Skype us at 954-99-0036. Anywhere in the world. 954-990-0036.
Since the 70s revival, it's a common scene in many doctors' offices.
You gotta tell me, please, why can't I dance?
Well, I'm afraid you have white meningitis.
No!
White meningitis, a tragic affliction causing so many to give up trying to get down.
Staying alive, oh yeah, staying alive, woo!
The symptoms are easy to spot. The inability to snap your fingers or clap your hands anywhere near the beat of music.
Wow, what a groove! Dig it, baby!
Your singing causes an instant gag reaction to all those standing next to you.
Oh, my God.
Smile every day with 77 WABC All America.
She's a little piece of ass, but from music she don't know. Sampling from the past, this was our song, you know. Made the bass line stronger, the mix is longer, on and on it goes. You really blow, you hoe. Enter a highway, that's the real.
Why is it doing that? All right, start it over again. I'm not ready. Hit the play button again. That thing just started.
We'll just start it from the beginning.
All right. Yeah, start it from the beginning.
She's a little piece of ass, but from music she don't know. Sampling from the past, this was our song, you know. Made the bass line stronger, the mix is longer, on and on it goes. You really blow, you hoe. Enter a highway, that's the real song. And it sucks that these morons who sample our old songs always do it wrong. The chorus is gone, this blow. But the target demo's unaware. The little Xerox pimple heads don't care. Your talons between your legs down there. I hope that you get lice in your pubic hair. Your pubic hair.
And we're back. 2 till 2, SoFloRadio.com, George Rodriguez, Boca Britt, and Byron just left. Byron is a trip, if ever there was one.
But it's
sure. And I mean, I didn't think to have, I thought we'd have a full house, or I would have invited Suds on the show today, but that's, you know, who knows where Suds is at any given moment, at any given time. Well, it's a Suds life. I want to, instead of a dog's life or life O'Reilly, I want to have like
Suds life.
It's like
I've been promoting the
giant breakfast every morning and
April 5th and show. So Suds, if you're out there listening, April 5, Friday,
we'll get that, and let me write that on my things to do, my to-do list. is it grows faster than I got. Oh, Captain Hook says, I forgot to tell Boca Britt that she looks good today.
Well, so, thank you. There you go. Very flattered.
Captain Hook with that the whiskey and cigarettes voice.
You need whiskey and cigarettes to say I look good.
I have, well, you have the cigarettes. I got some whiskey.
That's okay.
It's Fireball whiskey. Instant. It's really yummy.
I don't need whiskey to be convinced.
Give you instant heartburn, the Fireball whiskey.
Oh, no thanks.
But it's great. It mixes nice with coffee. Like, you want some cinnamon coffee with a kick? I could do a whole endorsement over Fireball whiskey. Speaking of Fireball, new person, new friend. I said that I would shout out to her. Her nickname is Fireball because when we met, we were spinning balls and watching other people spin balls and fire, and we were having a ball. And then she told me she lived in another state and had a boyfriend. So that was that.
Oh.
So now we're just friends. Hey, new listener. Fireball, and then I also want to, while I'm doing shout-outs, I want to thank Jeet for a wonderful evening last night of roller skating. See, I'm being very, I don't know what the word is, wholesome. I'm spending a lot of quality time with family and friends while I'm going through my divorce and resetting and reorganizing my life and just getting everything in order, just getting all my ducks in a row for the new second half of my life. And if it seems like my attitude might be a little different, it's because I've had to do a lot of reevaluating of my personality. And, you know, Boca, who's known me for just 20 years or so, you know, I have some character flaws, and one of them is that I'm a big fat pussy.
1990, matter of fact.
Yeah. I'm a nice person, and that's not a bad thing in and of itself. I don't think. I never thought it was a bad thing. But in this town, being a nice person, a good person, a person that trusts people, takes people at their word, it sets you up. It's like being a limping wildebeest around hyenas. Coming to this town and announcing to the world that you're a nice person and that you believe people and trust people just gets you preyed upon and victimized. And I hope you're not one of those people, Byron. Because all I do is give, and all I can hope for is that people will appreciate it enough not to fuck me over. And that has happened a lot since I started this little business. I don't want to mention people by name, but so many people have come around here, stayed long enough to download and have me install all the software on their computers, teach them how to use it all, and then they go off and do their own thing, and with not so much as a thank you or something. Makes you feel like a cheap slut. But whatever. And that's part of the, I don't know, issues I've been having lately is wondering if being a good person is a good idea in this town. Because it wasn't ever a problem until I came to this town. And it's probably because I lived in places where there were no predators, like in New Zealand. With the flightless birds. You know why they have kiwis and other flightless birds in New Zealand? Because they don't have any ground predators. And then the Europeans showed up with their cats. And the kiwis were like, what the hell is that now? And they're, you know, you have to have predator resistance to operate in this town. And I don't. I spent my formative years in places, country bumpkin places, where you could take people at their word. You couldn't really be a charlatan. You really couldn't be a con artist in places where I lived because you could only screw one person once and everybody would know about it. So and you'd have to leave town. Like, let's say you were a dishonest mechanic. Like, this town is wall to wall with dishonest mechanics. I found a couple of good ones that you can trust, that won't try to rip you off. They won't use you as a sheep. They won't try to fleece you when you go in there. But it just seems, I don't even know what the proportion is. It's just way too much. Way too many people in this town that only want to interact with you to get whatever they can get from you. And the people that have been raised in this town, that's this town, and they seem it's perfectly normal, and they have a method for determining whether or not somebody is lying to them and whether or not somebody is using them, or maybe just because everybody's trying to take, so nobody's going to give. You understand that all these predators are running around looking for somebody like me. So,
well, I have adopted the South Florida survivalist attitude, and that is, I don't give a shit anymore.
Oh,
don't care, because I gave up. You try so hard after a while, and you do get burned out. You broke your ass, setting this up, and
Yeah, and made a lot of mistakes. Continue to make mistakes.
It's not,
however,
it's not so much the mistakes; it's the lack of support. You know, it's one thing to have fans. It's one thing to have people that like what you do and enjoy your shows. It's another thing to have real, actual, tangible support, and that's what we lacked since July 2009.
Well, that's why, and I'm gonna. They have their own pre-generated spots, the radio loyalty people, and my opinion of them is, like, I'm not all excited, like, I'm not going to get a radio loyalty t-shirt and run around, because they've got a ways to go yet. But what is unique about their concept in a world where everybody is, look at the TV over here, is all these player options, all these different ways that you can listen to internet radio. When you think about the logic of it, and it reminds me of the blood trade and the organ trade, not the Oregon, the organ. In America, when you get an organ transplant, when someone gets an organ transplant, everybody makes money except for the person that donates the organ. When you get a blood transfusion, you have to pay for the blood. Everyone who handles the blood, you understand those blood mobiles that you see out in front of the theater and everything? That's a for-profit. That's not the American Red Cross. That's a for-profit organization. Okay. They want you to donate your blood for free. And then they make money. The person that's sticking the needle in your arm, the person driving the van, the person, everybody involved with the process of moving the blood from your body into someone else, they all get paid by the patient, except for the person donating it. Now, you have everybody that's listening right now is listening on something or another, and there's probably ads going on. If you're listening on your computer screen, there's probably an ad up there. If you're listening on an app, there's probably some ads, unless you paid for the full version of Spark Radio or TuneIn Radio or uTunes. I should have mentioned them. uTunes is also very a decent radio listening app. The advertisers pay the manufacturers of the app. The advertisers pay the platform, for example, Live 365 or Radio Loyalty or TuneIn. There are ads there. Advertisers pay to have their ads viewed. One of these platforms has decided to create an incentive for you to use their app and their player. You're going to have to use one anyway. Why don't you use the one that actually gives you green stamps while you use it? And I've told my friends, and I'm telling my family members, this is what I'm using. I can't use it on my phone as often as I would like to. I have to have good Wi-Fi, because at 128K you have a buffering problem. If you're on 3G, I'm still on 3G. Sorry, but if you're on 3G, it buffers. I'm gonna write them an email and say, look, you're doing yourself a disservice. You want to be a universal player for people. You've got to give people the option of broadcasting at a lower bit rate so that they don't run into buffering problems. And we're doing talk radio. 64K is fine. Fine. By the way, we encode and stream to Radio Loyalty at 128K. We sound great.
Yeah, we do.
On Radio Loyalty. We sound great at 128K. Not so much better that it makes it worth it to broadcast on 28K. Now, it's negligible. The quality level is negligible, especially when you're talking about the spoken word, which is what we market.
What were you doing initially, 64?
When we started with Eric?
Yeah, I think it was 64.
12.5. Oh. Are you ready for that? And that was Eric's idea, because now in those days, I got to say, people were still on dial-up. We've been doing this for so long. People were still on dial-up, and that was our goal. I wanted everybody to be able to listen to our programming without buffering, including the old lady still on dial-up. And times have changed. Not if you're still on dial-up, I don't go away. We're not even marketing to you. If you're still using dial-up, I don't even know. I don't know who you are. And homeless people, they grab their laptops.
They got droids.
And they grab their laptops and their droids and their iPads.
Yeah.
And they go and they sit in the parking lot of the Starbucks. Homeless people know how to get faster internet than dial-up. So give me a break. So then we switched to 32. Because people, and it sounded great, and it sounded wonderful. And 32 was fine, and we could still operate at 32. But all of these other people wanted 64. We record the shows at 64, everything 64, and it's the year I was born. It's a nice magic number. We'd like to be able to encode on Radio Loyalty on 64 so that you don't have the buffering problem. But they do. And their app looks like shit. I'm sorry. The print and everything is microscopic.
Yeah.
Like, if you look at the directory, you got to get a magnifying glass to read that shit. Is so small, the font and the type, and it just doesn't look nice. It doesn't look all glitzy. Nothing else is like that Spark Radio. They're the ones that are doing it right. If Radio Loyalty would get their app to look like the Spark Radio app or really any of the other apps, they would be really on to something.
All right, I'll go through the hoops.
I don't understand hoops. To be a listener, it just took an email address.
I'm like, I went on.
I don't even know. You got a computer
this.
In front of you. Ain't nobody got time for that. I don't understand the problems that you ran into. And I start my counter, like I told you, I've got like 90,000 points right now. And just to give you a ballpark what that is, at 100,000 points, you could get a hat or a T-shirt. And then if you want something like an iPad, that's like a million, like an iPod, that's like a million. You want an iPad, that's like 2 million, 3 million points. But whatever, turn on the player, tune in your favorite radio station, SoFloRadio.com. I highly encourage you to tune in SoFloRadio.com. And go to work. It'll eventually, just like any other website, it'll time out. Live 365 times out.
It does? See, my TuneIn doesn't, unless you tell it to.
Okay. TuneIn, the browser, the PC-based browser, TuneIn times out. You know, it doesn't time out are the phone apps, like Spark Radio and things like that. Oh, here's Alan Michaels. Ladies and gentlemen, I was wondering when we were going to hear from Alan. Hello,
I'm wearing
Alan.
Pants today, Mike.
Hey, good afternoon. How you doing? Hey, George, I don't think you're a cheap slut, but Boca, we got to talk. Yeah. Hey,
he's not cheap.
No, I'm not. Far from
so how you guys doing now that Byron's gone?
We're recovering good. Nicely.
It'll take a little while. I just want to say hi, and I have a special treat for you in just one moment today. But before we get to that, just a little plug that I'll be on at 3 on SoFlo and She. And today we have a special premiere of our newest station in the network, I-95. You remember I-95?
Yes.
Well, we brought it back. Another station back in our network that used to be on FM years ago, bumper-to-bumper hits. And this is top 40 hits on the charts now.
You got the floor. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just letting you talk,
check
Alan.
It
it's just
out
like
with
you
your
know.
Car and
here's another example of Alan likes to use this platform to promote other stations, but that's okay. Go right ahead. Just go ahead. Just
that's
pick
okay,
the,
but I don't
pick
put
the
a link on
bones.
The Facebook page to the stations because I realize that is sacred to SoFlo Radio, and that makes sense.
It's not sacred, but I'm going through a lot of effort to try to get people to come here. If they come to SoFlo Radio, they will be able to see and hear all these other radio shows, and there's a link to SoFlo Television and all of this stuff on there. So, you know, once they go to the SoFloRadio.com site, they'll be able to see all of us. It's not just for me. It's for us all together. It's a collective.
Right.
If they go to that station that you're promoting right now, they're not going to see the Pow Wow Show or the Byron Egger Show or the Nicole Sandler or By the Glass or JJ and Sam in the morning and Post Time, which is a great show on in the afternoon.
Well, but they will on the bottom of the page on every single one of our stations in the network show a link to the main network page. And on there is, of course, SoFlo Radio right at the top is the flagship station. So in a way, they are all the stations in our network cross-plug each other. But anyway, I got a special treat for you guys today. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Now, for years we've been speaking since the conception of SoFlo Radio. I've been an infrequent guest on your show, George, which I appreciate. But today, in town with me is my father, who's listening to your show for the first time.
Oh.
And he wants to say hello to you both.
Well, I'm excited about that. Is he nicer than you?
I told him, get ready, because he's going to put me down, Dad. Here we go. Say hi. Here we go. Gentlemen, how are you?
Hey, so you're the one responsible for Alan.
Hi, Alan's father.
I'm sure I made Alan. By the way, he speaks so highly of you gentlemen.
Well, I'll try not to hold it against you.
He loves you guys, really, he does.
Mm-hmm.
It's so nice to hear you. You guys are doing a bang-up job.
Well, thank you so much.
I don't care what he says. I like you guys.
We don't care what he says either.
Yeah, we ignore him completely.
Are you
I'm
back
sure you
on the
too.
Phone now? Where'd he go?
Okay. Hey, that's Al.
Don't know where
fast.
He went. He's hiding again.
Follow the cigarette smell.
You guys, that's right. I'm following it now. Here, he wants to talk to you.
Just follow the trail of smoke.
I love that. That was great. Thank you so much.
We're here for you, Alan.
Actually, he been listening to a lot of reruns since he came into town of your show, and we were into a show that I was on a couple weeks ago, and he goes, I don't think they like you.
Oh, I love Alan.
So anyway, it was great to get him on live because he's having the time of his life. My father's 80 years old and has gone through a lot of health issues lately. So to have him in town is a pleasure, and to share the SoFlo experience with him is really great. But anyway, thanks for that treat today, and we'll catch you live after 3. So what else is going on? Anything?
I love it when Alan, when I tell Alan that he's got to leave, that I have to go, I have to do something, I have to go pick up my daughter or something, and he's visiting the studio, I say, Alan, you have to go. And his response to that is, so what else is going on?
So, Alan, how's that glow in the dark
instead
wallpaper?
Instead of goodbye, he says, so what else is going on? And then he leans back in his chair. I said, you're going in the wrong direction. What should be going on is you standing up and walking out the door. Yeah, I'll leave in a minute. No, Alan, you need to be moving.
I know, but what the folks don't realize, because they can't see this, is when you exit the SoFlo studios, there are so many steps that take you down, like you're going into a dungeon.
A flight.
That you actually have to prepare to leave. I'll never forget when we had Craig Worthing, famous talk show host from Miami, on as a guest on your show, and it was time for him to leave, and he's going down the steps going, this reminds me of the Munsters TV show.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess it is a trip to get down those steps, especially with the lighting that we provide.
I'd like you to trip going down those steps.
I knew it. I knew there's something coming up. Well, anyway, Byron made it down the steps today, right?
Yes, Alan. Yeah.
Okay.
He glided down there. In fact, George installed one of those chairs.
A lot of stuff makes sense, and I do recommend that Radio Loyalty Player also, and that's not a plug that has anything to do with me. That's just a great device, and if you listen through there, it's a benefit to the listeners and the station.
Right, that is the player that I would. You're going to have to use a player of some sort anyway. Anytime that you launch, and I don't know, I'm going to put the direct stream back on there. I don't care. But if you're going to use a player, you might as well use the one that that compensates you. It's about time that they cut the listener in on some of the ad revenue.
Absolutely.
And they've got other things, like, you know the thing, like, there's stuff that pops up on there, like, hey, just click on this ad and get 250 points just to look at our ad. Okay, there, bang, 250.
Yeah, I mean, what device lets you score points, maybe a vacation, just by listening to a radio station through the player? You're going to listen through something anyway.
Right.
So by listening to SoFlo,
you don't have to click
radio
on it. You can just dial it up. Press, you know, you don't have to press play. You just hit that radio loyalty thing and then turn your computer screen off. You don't have to look at the ads on there.
Absolutely, but you can win a vacation, points for prizes. It's just, it's really a great thing. You can never score from a real radio station that way by having it on your car.
Right.
Because besides for the ratings, they have no idea whether you're listening or not.
Right. As opposed to Live 365, that puts a secret subliminal encoding feature on there that talks you into being gay subconsciously while you're listening.
Hey, this is interesting. I got a call this week from a survey, was asking if you feel there's a need for another television station to be competition with Fox News. And it was definitely coming from a very conservative organization.
That's a waste of time. They're already working on it.
They're working on it, right?
Yeah.
And according to what I was hearing on the survey, it's like it's going to be on the air any day. And this is like going to be a big nationwide cable channel competing with Fox. So that was news to me. And I don't know why they're calling me, because I'm a liberal Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
They don't care. They
know that.
Well, I know everybody knows that.
They know it now.
Take any promotion they can get.
Well, everybody, people calling you up to do a phone survey don't know what your politics are. What is that? That's part of caller ID now?
Yeah, well, then, of course, they want to know at the end of the survey about your demos, after they get done asking you about your political point of view and if you feel it's necessary. Really, the whole survey was, in essence, is Fox News just, you know, basically, are they just one-pointed in one direction? Is there room for another conservative outlet?
Alan, what was the original name of Fox News in 1997?
That's a good question, Boca. Brian, do I win a prize for that? I got to tell you, I think, I got to remember
it
because...
It's easy. GOP TV.
Who would remember that?
And if they kept that, it would have been fine, because that's exactly
what
it is.
That's exactly what they are, sure.
But since the fairness doctrine went away, they could call it news.
And remember, because there was a lawsuit.
After this,
you don't have to be accurate. The news doesn't have to tell the truth.
I honestly feel that the big high point for Republican radio overall peaked at the last election, and I think we'll see some changes now busting across with all different points of view coming on the radio sooner or later, because I think they're starting to lose money, actually, just pushing the Republican crap down people's throats. So I think
their audience is dying off. Their demo is 75 and up.
Yeah, right. Well, and we all know about the slant that locally, of course, and nationally through Clear Channel in general. You know, if I'm not wrong, Mitt Romney's family has something to do with the Clear Channel organization. So well, if course. That's if
his
that
company, Bain Capital owns it. That's what. It's not his family. It's his. And I'm sure he still has a couple of fingers involved with that.
Yeah, but you know, in the old days of radio, if you could tarnish a radio show by somebody's political view, whether it was a good show and spoke of good character on the air, made no sense at all in the old days of radio. Of course, today anything goes. It's like the Wild Wild West out there. It's just open territory for anything these days, because the economy is so bad overall that people are struggling to do what they can to make a dollar. So I really don't think it matters on your political view. I think it matters on how green your dollar is, or if you're going to be able to be on the air and have a voice in this country. And it looks like that's where things are going. But anyway, that's enough politics out of me. I got to get ready to rock and roll. So listen, we'll be on at 3 today live, and maybe a little plug there, a live remote from our new station, I-95.
Okay.
All right, guys, keep rocking. We'll check you later. I'm back to caretaking with Dad.
Okay.
All right. Nice meeting your father.
Thanks, guys. Thank you very much. Bye.
You can break it. Oh, now that I'm into this song. This is what Alan reminds me of. Because after a while, 30 seconds or something like that, Alan's voice starts sounding like El Chombo.
Here, I'll make you feel at home. I'll have a cigarette. And, you know, I have to blow out of here at 3.
Right.
Because I got to dash home and do one of those...
What, a poop?
A Claire Dane scrub.
A psychic reading?
The Claire Dane scrub.
I don't know what that isn't. Oh, the Claire Dane. You have to swab your cooch.
Why did they have to put that scene in there?
That was the best scene in the movie, and I'm watching that with my daughter and the future son-in-law, and we're all looking at each other and we're like, oh, it's terrorism. It's anti-terrorism. It's like 24. It's, you know, all anti-terrorist programming is right-wing, well, not right-wing, because the military-industrial complex has bought up both wings, as you know. But all of the anti-terrorist hysteria arm-flapping shit is supposed to make us really, really scared so that we'll keep funneling money into the military as if it's military spending that will defend us from people who hate us, right? Maybe they hate us because we spend a lot of money on our military, and then our military goes over there to the other side of the world, and then starts blowing people up and their children.
Might have something to do with it, yes.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a relief to know that women in high-level top security meetings smell nice.
Well, they
are hygienically clean.
They have wipes. They have specialty.
What is that?
They have special wipes.
Anyone who was watching the pilot of that show will know what we're talking about.
Yeah, well, and we didn't get through. We got 10, 15 minutes into it. And it's like, oh, yeah, terrorism. Ooh, terrorist. Ooh.
Terrorism. What are you thinking about with the drones? Go ahead.
Yeah, the government uses the veil, the threat of terrorism to promote things, to get pushed through legislation like the Patriot Act and things like that. And the whole... Like the whole thing with the drones, and I really like the job that the Daily Show has been doing on that. And why you understand, see, here's the thing, because I'm very disillusioned with Obama also, but he's still way better than everything else that they were running, that especially the Republicans were running. But you know why he's sending drones to blow up Muslims, even though they're American citizens? It's because of all these freaking birthers and teabaggers accusing him of being a Muslim. I'll show them how Muslim I am. I'll start murdering some.
Nothing he does will work.
Nothing he does will work, but, well, shut down Guantanamo like you said that you would. It's like, I'll keep this promise here and I'll keep this promise there. Shut down Guantanamo. Do something with those people. Put them on trial or let them go. It's just like on ice forever. Very, very un-American. And they say, well, they're not American citizens. Well, they're prisoners of war. Then try them and let them go. They're just cooling their heels there. And the interrogation and all that stuff. I thought we were supposed to be the good guys. I thought we were supposed to be the ones that wear white hats. Good guys don't torture people. If they torture people and we torture people, then it's just us against them. How can you say that God's on your side when you torture people?
It was easy to promote torture for the non-combative politicians who never served. Because it wouldn't be their ass in a torture chamber. And that was...
Cheney? You talking about Cheney?
Yeah, of course. Would he had a cyst on his ass. He got five deferments. He wouldn't have any problem with the Geneva Convention because he was never in.
Right.
Never mind the people.
I heard he visited Geneva.
Yeah.
Man, so many things. Let's take
a break.
He's
got a bank account there.
When we come back, I'll try to figure out what... And I like that I had it because this is, you know, if the audience got bored with all the shop talk. Sorry, this is what's going on. That's not shop talk. That's news. That's cutting edge internet broadcasting news. What's going on? That we're not at the front of it. We're way before the front of it. As things avail themselves, as technology avails itself, as the times change and the way that people listen to radio change, we're poised. We're poised on it. We're poisoned on it.
Oh, by the way, it's the 10th anniversary of Iraq, so going into the break.
CNN, you got some stats handy over there because, what is it, like $3 trillion, $5 billion,
$150,000 dead.
150,000 dead, including almost 5,000 Americans. You know, they killed 3,000 Americans, so we responded to that by killing 5,000 Americans.
Yeah.
And you see, and now that we did that, now that we invaded Iraq and Afghanistan and spent a kajillion trillion dollars and had and killed 5,000 American soldiers to kill 150,000 people, terrorism's over and they love us now.
Everything's fine.
Everything's fine, see? They don't hate us anymore now. All those reasons that they had for attacking us in the first place, we totally eliminated all of those reasons and we killed all the terrorists and now everything's fine. See what great policy that was.
So relax.
Thank you, Military Industrial Complex. 225, SoFloRadio.com.
We thought he had weapons of mass destruction. It turns out he didn't.
Eastern world will be exploded. Saddam had people killed with the gas that we sold him. First time aggressor nation and the only one that's going. Now more blood will be spilled to get that oil flowing. Forget about Korea and the nukes they're toting. And the right wing is drilling it over and over into our heads that Iraq has some weapons of mass destruction.
What did Iraq have to do with what?
God damn it. Hit it again. I'm going to blow that thing out of there and put it in. You know what? You're going to have to use the SAM broadcaster from now on. I think that the days are over.
He didn't.
The Middle Eastern world will be exploded. Saddam had people killed with the gas that we sold him. First time aggressor nation and the only one that's going. Now more blood will be spilled to get that oil flowing. Forget about Korea and the nukes they're toting, and the right wing is drilling it over and over into our heads that Iraq has some weapons of mass destruction.
What did Iraq have to do with what?
The attack on the World Trade Center.
Nothing. Nobody's ever suggested that the attacks of September the 11th were ordered by Iraq.
3,000 people killed are now forgotten. Let's exploit him instead. Hey, there's oil to be gotten. Going after Saddam to placate Osama. There's no longer mention of the name Bin Laden. But no one seems concerned, all comfy and complacent. Believing every word of this cartel administration that controls us by fear through media manipulation. And the right wing is drilling it over and over into our heads that Iraq has some weapons of mass destruction.
You gotta keep repeating things over and over and over again for the truth to sink in. Got to catapult the propaganda.
There is no doubt that Saddam Hussein now has weapons of mass destruction.
The loss of civil rights is the price that we're paying. We're all suspects now, Nazi Ashcroft is saying. I have nothing to hide, table talkers all are saying. Blind, obedient cattle don't have any reservation. About unprovoked battle and world annihilation. Old regimes must fall and Halliburton installed. With no objection at all, Democrats don't have the balls. And the
right wing is drilling it over and over into our brainwashed heads. Iraq has some weapons of mass destruction. Only Iraq has some weapons of mass destruction.
Why bother listening to those other douchebags? While we've got everything you need right here. SoFloRadio.com. Radio you've missed.
That methane from between your legs will sometimes smell like cheese or eggs, but mine smells like onions. Butter, bacon, any kind of bean will make it difficult to keep my underwear clean. Fat. Phew, it smells like onions. Onion smells blow out my butt from the gases in my gut. Vapor doo-doo, vapor poop. Onion smells between my cheeks, always smells okay to me. Vapor doo-doo, vapor.
Are you constantly on the go, trying to improve your status quo? Well, good for you and lots of luck, but you need help when making a buck.
Keep in the know with Living Radio. Keep on the go with Living Radio. On your mark, get set, ready, go with yours truly, WQAM.
This old Ford driving, I'm stuck behind him. On the steering wheel I see two shaky hands. This man is dying, why is he driving? How he keeps his license, I don't understand. If he went any faster, he would wind up going backwards. And I'm stuck behind a geezer, yes, I'm stuck behind a geezer who's an asshole. Stuck behind a geezer, yes, a 90-year-old geezer, what an asshole. Stuck behind a geezer, yes, I'm stuck behind a geezer who's an...
Yeah, we're just going to give up on that. I'm just giving Boca Bryan a lesson on what we're going to use instead of the virtual DJ. It's too bad. And that was a great score. More shop talk. That was a great score because all these other media players, the Windows Media Player, iTunes, even the Media Monkey, they don't do smart segueing, as I call it. You can pre-program them to segue with 5 seconds left. That's what the iTunes thing does. Okay.
I think the software is corrupted on this. You may have to reload.
Yeah, well, that computer is ancient. I've only had that computer for like 12 years. Computers in the studio are dying one after another. I got two in the shop right now. So
they're dying over here.
Yeah, it used to be a good thing, but then it wasn't. I highlighted a whole bunch of stuff that I wanted to hit on.
Go ahead.
Real quickly before we settle on to something. These are stories going all the way back. I part of my morning routine, I check in with JJ and Sam in the morning and Captain Hook. And listen to Nicole, and during their breaks, etc., I pop on CNN. I have the mute on, so I get a little scroll on there. And here's a story that I thought cracked me up, because I make fun of the commercial. As we're watching CNN during the show here a lot, they always have the ad for Christian Mingles, Christian Singles. Wait, ChristianMingle.com. You remember?
Yeah.
I would talk about that, because of the language that they use on that commercial is find God's choice for you. Uh-huh. And this ties right in with what I've been screaming about on religion for a long time. It's like, who are you to tell me what God wants me to do? Which is my problem with religion. It isn't about whether or not God exists. That isn't my point when I am debating religion with people. That's okay, sure, God exists, and there's a God up there and he created the universe and everything. The problem that I have is one jackball telling another jackball what God wants you to do. I have a message for you from God. Well, why didn't God tell me? He doesn't have my cell phone number. I'm sure God knows how to find me. Why is it that God gave you my message? If God knows how to find you to deliver a message, why did he tell you my message? Why didn't he tell me my message? Well, probably the commercial will probably come up because I'm on CNN right now. So a rapist was trolling ChristianMingle.com, hooking up with people and then raping them.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. I've been telling people for years, con artists, people who prey on people who trust, like yours truly, con artists, their favorite hunting grounds are church, because they're collected all conveniently, assembled for their victimization pleasure, as people who are faith-based people, who believe stories that they like the sound of. They hear a story, they like the sound of it, they go, okay. They don't ask follow-up questions. They just accept people and what they say based on some weird voodoo magic criteria of their very own. Typically, it sounded good to my head. It sounded good in my ear. I want to believe that story, therefore I believe that story. So con artists always wish that those people would just gather together in one place so that they could just victimize one after another. And they're called churches. Churches are where the sheep gather, and then the wolves go hunting there. And here, same thing, ChristianMingle.com. Here are a bunch of people that all you got to do is say, I love Jesus, and they'll hook up with you. And you have a bit, the phony holy born again.
Coming up. Oh, if it'll play.
For those purposes. So anyway, ha ha ha, don't go to ChristianMingle.com, you'll get raped. And don't listen to Live365.com, you'll get AIDS. I'm just going to go through these really quickly. The last time that we had a show, we were discussing, I was discussing the gun issue and how to deal with it. And I kept screaming, I'm saying the policies of prohibition don't work. Now, they don't work in America, they backfire. Whenever the government tries to tell people that they can't do something or tries to pass a law restricting someone from doing something that they feel they have the right to do, they create the opposite effect. People like to defy the government, like little children saying, you tell me I can't have another cookie? Well, I'm just going to steal the cookie behind your back. Yeah. That is the attitude of the American people. I agree with all pragmatic, logical people that the fewer weapons of death that we have running around in our society, the safer we are. That's a no-brainer. You'd be much safer if there were no guns in America. However, the way to get people to relinquish their firearms and the way to get people to not have all these guns around is not by passing a law, but by good PSAs, the same way that we've reduced cigarette smoking. And case in point, and this was on CNN, in the time, this story is like, what, a month old, two months old, CNN on the crawl, gun sales didn't just skyrocket. After that, the school shooting thing, the school shooting thing happened. Politicians started opening up a mouth, crying for gun control. And what was the reaction by the women of America? Gun sales among women up 73% since that massacre. They didn't go and buy the guns because there was a massacre. They bought the guns because they heard people in politics say, we're going to pass some gun control laws. And of course, you know what the right-wing propaganda machine, they take a statement like that, like we're going to revisit our gun laws to make it more difficult for crazy people to get guns. That is the reasonable, rational statement that came from some people in politics. But what that got twisted into by the NRA and Rush Limbaugh and all the people is the Democrats are coming to take your guns away. So, of course, everybody ran out and started arming themselves to try to get their gun supply before the government took the guns away, even though that's not at all what was suggested. That's not at all what was being pushed for. But there you go. You're feeding the monster. You're feeding the opposition material by the language that you use and by the political posture that you take with regards to an issue like this. It is a very serious issue. By the way, I put a copy of the Constitution in the bathroom. I don't know if you noticed the bookcase.
Is that what I wiped with?
Might have. I have an extra one over here. I have the shit-covered and the non-shit-covered version of the Constitution.
Told you to get a bidet. Don't listen to me.
One day I'll get a bidet. I thought you were going to get me the swing out bidet. I had one of those, and it was a bitch to clean.
No, what I'll get you is very simple to maintain.
Daily, I'm just going to go through these things because then we want to spend some time on the Pope. Daily Show had I don't even remember how long ago this was. Too long. Daily Show had a report about women in combat, and you know they do a thing on the Daily Show besides give you accurate news. That I like is their play on words.
Yeah.
And it's, I think Samantha, what's her name? Is that her name?
Samantha B.
She's hysterical. Everyone is on that show. And they were using terms like brohesion. The women in the military are going to interfere with the brohesion of the combat unit and disrupt the dynamics of the combat unit. I love all these little quips.
Yeah, like, I'm going to miss him over the summer.
Yeah. What's that noise coming? Hang on.
It's doing. I don't know.
Oh, it's that computer. So there we go.
This one?
Yeah.
Oh.
You know what? It's my wires.
He's doing a movie on it.
They're gone. Boy, that was reminiscent of the very beginning of our Enterprise here. Remember that phantom hum that took me 3 months to find? Where's that hum coming from?
Oh, incidentally, because we weren't on when this story happened, but I so happen to have the audio of Oscar Pistorius running from the scene of the crime, of the murder.
You got that handy? Why was I ready for that?
Okay.
Old news. I have to comment. This is like Paul Harvey news and comments. I wanted to comment on these things, but I don't have a lot of time, so I'm just going to tear right through real quick. Did you see the news story about the tourists that were attacked in Mexico at a resort?
That I did not
see. This is a month or two ago. Six women were raped. They had, and it was a resort. They had a beach house bungalow thing, which is nice, open to the beach where you can just like walk out of your back area, and it's right there on the beach and everything. Mexican banditos, stormed the house where the people were staying, tied the men up and raped the six women that were there, and then, of course, robbed them blind.
Must be Republicans.
No, okay. What I was going to say to people is, don't go to Mexico ever for any reason. Why do people go to Mexico?
I don't.
I know you don't, but there's a tourism industry.
Maybe to hide.
I'm not talking about them. Tourists go to Mexico. I'm not making this up. They do.
No, I mean, isn't there? We don't have an extradition law with them.
I don't know what we have. It's Mexico.
Okay.
The Mexican economy is robbing tourists. Then of course, you know, we shipped a lot of jobs down to Mexico, and I mean, they got that economy too. We buy something, and the money goes to either China.
Did any
or
of
Mexico.
The rapists resemble Eli Wallach?
No, they all looked like the Frito Bandito. They were all really squat with square feet.
Oh, I see.
Don't go to Mexico. Don't visit Mexico. Remember what I told Neil a while back?
Yeah.
Don't go on vacation to a place where people are risking their lives to get out of there. Does that make sense to you? People are risking their lives to escape that country and come to America. As bad as things are in America, there are people risking their lives to come here. So why you would leave here to go to the place where people are desperately trying to get out of?
Well, why
defies
is it
a little bit of logic.
I do have a question, though, regarding Mexico City. It seems
Mexico
like a happening place.
It's happening all right. The Mexico City sewer system dumps all of its sewage into the river that flows downstream, whereupon the raw sewage dries upon the banks. And then
driving
the wind
high-end
blows it
cars and stuff and got nice apartments. It's like somebody's making money there.
Well, you understand in the third world structure, you can't have peasants without there being a few people, a minority, kind of like it is in America, a small percentage of people that own everything and control everything. Those people, that percentage of people, they have a lot of money and they can afford expensive cars and clothes, et cetera, and so on.
That's what it is.
The rest of the people are desperate. They're desperate. And I don't want to blame the fact that they prey on tourists as a side effect of their desperation. Whatever. You're hungry. You're an asshole. You know, these whole Mexican drug wars that are going on, are you reading about that? They're killing politicians. They're killing officials. They're killing cops. They kidnap. These people cross the border, go into America, kidnap business owners, take them back across the border, smuggle them back, since they're experts at smuggling people across the border through tunnels and through the hidden compartment and the panel vans. They smuggle the kidnapped victims and the wheel wells back to Mexico, where then they ransom them. And then if you're lucky, you after paying the ransom, you get the person back. Otherwise, they just take the money and, you know, and kill the victim and whatever. Don't go to Mexico. Don't live anywhere near Mexico. Not a shot of Mexicans. God bless you if you're a Mexican. But Mexico sucks. Don't go there. That's my advice. You go to Mexico and get kidnapped, raped, murdered, or something, don't say I didn't warn you. Don't go to Mexico. You don't hear about these stories coming up constantly about other places, do you? Oh, Colombia. Don't go to Colombia.
I won't be. I won't be going to Uganda anytime soon either.
No. And don't go to Cuba until they lift that embargo.
Well, unless you want to collect those old cars. you know, if you have a way to bring them
I
back.
Still, I found that movie. It's actually on here. I have that Yank Tanks.
You do have it?
I have it on my hard drive.
You know, I really would like to see that.
Do you have the ability to watch a video on your TV if you have the video file, or should I burn a DVD?
Well, I could, either way.
It takes a long time to burn it.
If it's a file, yeah. I can watch it on my computer.
Yeah. Well, one of these days, you'll get... These things are going to be very standard very soon. Already, the people that I know that have the new TVs, just internet cable right into it. As a matter of fact, the same cable that brings in their the cable, mm-hmm. if it has internet, the TV will tune in the internet from that same cable. Oh, the world. Oh, how it's going. Oh, how it's moving.
Okay.
Isn't that exciting and nice? I have a food truck report. We have the food truck roundup here in Hollywood, as they do in a lot of other places around our community. South Florida area. Mm-hmm. Have you been to a food truck roundup lately?
No, and I'd like to go.
It's all the rage. Well, every Monday on the Circle, food truck roundup. And I'm walking by. You know, some of these food trucks, you've seen them here and there. You've seen individual food trucks here and there. A lot of them, I would say most of them, predictable stuff. Like, here's the one that has the burgers and fries and, you know, the fried food. Here's the one that has the pizza. Here's the one that has this. There's a food truck, there, and I'm walking around. Actually, and this goes back to, I have a story, because you know I'm a fire breather now. Did you know that?
What else is new? after what you had for lunch.
Do you see the costume over there? Do you see the, right over there to your right? The big dragon head? That's part of my outfit.
This here?
Yeah.
With the big nose?
Well, the nose isn't part of the costume. I just put that dragon hat on there.
Oh, okay.
I put that on and a cape and knee-high boots, utility belt, and a muscle shirt with a devil, a flaming devil head on the front.
I still can't go through the grocery store without laughing when I pass by the muscle milk. I'm sorry.
It'll make you muscular.
What they call it?
Muscle
that.
Milk.
Muscle milk.
It came from your muscle, and it's for your muscle.
Pulsating muscle milk.
So I'm meeting. I want to thank Jimmy from Spinballs.com and the professional fire handler. I think that's what it's called collectively, who taught me how to be a fire breather. But on our first meeting, we were going to meet at the food truck roundup. So I'm killing time, and I discover a food truck that I'm going to follow this food truck around. If I see this food truck driving down the road, I'm going to like make a U-turn, an illegal U-turn, and just follow it to wherever it's going. You've heard of Andrew Zimmern? He's the squat, bald-headed guy that's always eating testicles as food.
No.
All right. I think he's on the Food Channel. You know, they have all these food shows, and they've more than one show where a host travels the world and eats exotic things. And this is one of those kinds of shows. Andrew Zimmern, his specialty is testicles. Indeed, on the side of the food truck, they have a plasma TV.
He hasn't called me.
They open up a compartment. You wouldn't want him to eat your testicles, considering what he does with them.
Okay.
It slices, they broil them in oil. I mean,
I see. All
right. Right there on the side of the truck, they open up a panel, and there's the a plasma screen so that the people that are eating the food that they got from the food truck, or the people that are just walking by, might be compelled to get something from the food truck. Here are clips from the show. And what are they showing clips of? Him eating, preparing testicles.
Well, what's the point of that?
Bull testicles. Because it's exotic. And this is the point that I'm getting to. The Andrew Zimmern food truck, I thought sure they were going to have testicles on the menu. And I wasn't going to order any. Just so, you know, mm-hmm. I cannot think of anything. I don't know. I'll eat monkey brains before I eat bull testicles.
I'm so fucking annoyed.
Thank you. Oh, that'd be great if they had a Gordon Ramsay food truck.
Yeah, they look like fucking camel's turd.
You know, they might. I wouldn't be surprised if they did. But they had all kinds of weird exotic things, because that's what Andrew Zimmern specializes in, is different things. So they had pork bellies, they had gumbo, they had cabrito, which is young goat. It's the veal equivalent of goat. And I had a cabrito hot dog. I just kept going back to that food truck. And then I had the gumbo, and then I had something else there. They ran out of pork bellies. I went back. I was going to just pig out on everything on the menu in that truck. I was going to have some pork bellies. And they ran out.
How was the caprito?
It was great. And and it had zing. It had spice. It was really yummy. So if you are at a food truck roundup, it's big yellow. It says AZ Cantina. The AZ Cantina is the name of the truck.
Okay.
AZ for Andrew Zimmern. And everything on the menu was phenomenal. Especially the gumbo. I haven't had gumbo like that since New Orleans. Just really spicy.
What was in the gumbo?
Shrimp and clams and
conventional stuff.
Yeah, not testicles. I asked the guy. It's like, any balls in any of this? No. The answer was no.
Harry Reid cooked that dish.
you got to know Andrew Zimmern personally and have him invite you to his restaurant before he'll serve you up some testicles. But that,
I've
that,
eaten this shit.
Yeah, that's all they were. That's all they were doing on there. Somebody posted all over Facebook these days. I really want to thank my Facebook friends for the quality of their postings lately. A lot of funny memes, interesting videos, and George Carlin stuff that I may or may not have seen. Somebody posted a video about how to interact with the police, and it was very informative. I would say half of the stuff in there I didn't already know. This is news you can use. How to behave. Most of, I have a good copitude. Mm-hmm. I have a good attitude when the police are on the scene. I have not in my memory, in my life, have I ever had a problem with cops. Occasionally, when I was repoing cars, you would get an asshole cop. But that was specific to that situation. You understand that the asshole cop sees somebody, to them, to their eyes, it's stealing a car. And they go into asshole mode. So it doesn't matter, I'm wearing a dress shirt and I got paperwork sticking up out of my pocket, and I keep saying over and over again, I'm the recovery agent, I'm repossessing this car, I'm a recovery agent representing Sun Bank, repossessing the car. Doesn't matter, they still like that. They got to throw you to the ground and put their knee in your neck and put the cuffs on, because after all, I got this Batman utility belt that you paid for, so I want to use some of this stuff on it. Mm-hmm. Don't make me mace you. Don't make me tase you, bro.
Well, I find with my interaction with the police is that I always go easy on the menu.
Yeah.
They appreciate that.
All right. So, the gem that I got from this is when cops stop you, what you're supposed to say is, I don't consent to searches. And everybody should be on the same page about this. When a cop stops you and asks to search your car, you, for your own sake, you should say, no, thank you. I don't consent to searches. I do not consent to this search. I don't want to. Because understand something, that if the cop searches your car and finds anything in there, that's your ass. Even if it, let's say you had a passenger in your car. Let's say you lent your car to a friend. Let's say the previous owner left a roach in the seat cushion or something. Mm-hmm. They can bust you for that. If you don't consent to the search and they search your car anyway and bring the dog or something like that, the fact that you didn't consent can still be used as a defense to say that the search was illegal, because you have a right to your person and your property and your place. And so just don't. They might search you anyway, but just don't. Don't consent to the search.
Otherwise, they'll send your ass straight to FAU.
They cannot arrest you for not consenting to a search. And if they do, then that's something that you can use in your defense. So do not, if a cop comes to your door, do not let them in. You understand? Even if it's a cop comes to your door, and they had some real-life examples. This video that I saw was really good. Real-life example, real testimonials and stories from people, like little old ladies, the real events that happened. Little old lady says, hey, ma'am, I'm here. Need to ask some questions. There was some blah blah, some incident in the neighborhood. May I come in and ask you some questions? Little old lady allows the cop in. Cop finds something. Her grandson was smoking a joint there in the backup bedroom. They found a roach. They arrested her. All right.
Yeah.
If a cop comes to your house for a very innocent purpose, mm-hmm. like to ask questions about something that's been going on in the neighborhood, do not let them in. Anything that they find after you let them in can be used against you. Do not let them in. Say no thank you. Say, leave me your card, I'll go down to the police station and make a statement. Leave me your card, I'll call you up and I'll make a statement. Wait right there, I'll come outside and have a conversation. Do not consent to let them in your house. Do not let them in. Say no thank you. Like vampires, they can't hurt you if you don't let them in your house.
Right.
You have to give them permission to cross your threshold, because you just don't know what's going to happen. And by the way, cops are allowed to lie. That's another little thing that I got. Cops are allowed to lie to you. They're allowed to say, if you cooperate, we will this, and psych, I was lying.
Yeah, that goes way back, though.
Cops are lying. They can say that, they can come to your door and say that I'm here to talk to you about an incident down the block that you may or may not know something about, but really they're there to look for evidence because they think that you might be up to something. Cops are allowed to lie to you. Do not let them in your car. Do not consent to a search. Do not let them in your house. Very useful information.
Otherwise, you wind up at FAU.
And now that Pope.
Oh, there you go. Here we come.
Yeah.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the Pope. I've been waiting for your bird's eye perspective on this.
Pope Jorge. Let's start with all of the wonderful commonalities here. His name is Jorge. He's a spick. All right? They changed his name to Pope Francis.
The sissies.
That's my mom's name. All right? He looks just like Neil. Oh my God. Maybe 10 posts on my Facebook. I shared all of them. The people in the Neil Rogers group, all of the Neelys. I'm getting emails from people with side-by-side pictures. If you want to laugh, it's facebook.com/TheGeorgeRodriguez, or you can, follow links or something like that. And you'll see a bunch of wonderful side-by-side pictures, including some Photoshop things of this new Pope Jorge.
Pope Jorge.
Otherwise known as George.
Right. And God, strike me dead if this doesn't look like Neil's twin. I mean, and it is. It's poetic justice. It's wonderful. It's heartwarming. Oh, the comments. Funny stuff on my Facebook. Thank you, people, for all of the wonderful pictures of Neil and the Pope. And Billy Corbin posted a picture. Everybody was just finding pictures of the Pope that looked just like Neil.
Speaking of Corbin, I finally did see Cocaine Cowboys.
By the way, not just an interesting movie, but if he doesn't have a snappy storytelling documentary style, then nobody does.
Yeah, oh, it was good. It was on CNBC.
The edits, the way they would edit, you know, clips and this and that on CNBC. I've seen it like twice, three times, and then you see Cocaine Cowboys 2 and also Square Grouper. That's good. Billy's been on the show. He's been here in the studio. Here is a multi-talented guy. He's funny. He's funny speaking. He can write funny. He's a great director, a great storyteller. And a marvelous singer, and a songwriter. He wrote the theme to Square Grouper, which I have here. I could play it. I played it when he was on the show. Billy Corbin, a Pip, another little guy. The little guy with just
he's more talent
than that body can contain. Billy Corbin, not the lead singer of the Smashing Pumpkins. I have to correct people all the time. No, the other guy.
Fabulous.
And Mr. Miami, man, he's like a spokesperson for this town, like nobody else. And I think he's got a radio show somewhere or something. But, hey, Billy, you want to have a radio show?
That's what he uses, Mr. Miami?
No, that's my name for him because he's a local. I don't know if he was born down here, but he knows everything about this town. He just loves all of the history of this town. His movies are largely about this town, and he knows every haunt, every dive. We went karaokeing. Well, I didn't know that's what was going on. We went to a piano lounge after one of these meetings that we were at, one of these film festival events, and he's a marvelous singer. And I told you, he did the theme from Square Grouper. So a good guy, and huge Neely, Billy Corbin. So like Sir Daryl, huge Neely, huge Phil Hendry fan. I was going to get him on as early as next week, but I haven't gotten the email from him that I was waiting for with the appropriate technical specifications and the show box and everything. It's going to be a very busy weekend. Look, it's raining again.
Well, I'll be able to do more intercourse with your show once I get the delivery of this 755, which
everybody,
is a nice tower.
Everybody with their computer problems. Well, yeah, once we get up and running, I've got the Skype, too. I still want to do this, even though Eric didn't think that it would sound good. I would like to test that theory to see if we can conjoin studios Skype to Skype. I don't know how to get us both on the video, but because every time I install that software, it explodes whatever computer.
Maybe I'll be able to do it. This is a super big thing I'm getting.
Okay.
In fact, you come over and check it out in the computer, too. Next time you go out to Oral Springs.
You can man the video.
Yeah, exactly.
You can man the camera. Man the Ustream producer. Headline is this bitch that killed her, Jodi Arias, is the trial du jour. Let me change this because I don't understand. She's cute enough, but I don't understand these obsessions.
If they're cute.
Right. And now the latest news du jour, and I don't believe this lady for a minute. The baby that got shot, fishy from the very beginning. This story broke yesterday while I was watching the news. This woman was screaming. Whenever they see, here's the thing: if somebody shoots your baby, you should not be calm enough to talk to the police. If somebody shoots you in the leg and then shoots your baby in a stroller, you should not be calm enough to tell the police a story that doesn't exactly ring true. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You're a father. I'm a father. If something like that happened to one of my children, I would be a blathering, drooling mess for a week.
Yeah.
To be able to do an interview on TV, like all these people, like, what was her name with the kid in the drowning? Susan Smith? The kid in South Carolina.
That was,
they do these press conferences.
She blamed it on a black guy.
Yeah, they're all calm. Well, this chick blamed it on a couple of kids, and now they're trying to. I mean, it'll come up, the update. I don't know where we're at with that story right now. But and they're showing pictures of George, the baby, the toddler that was in the stroller. They're looking for her husband or the baby daddy or something, and they're showing the neighborhood where it was. And
shoot them in the head.
Yeah, I don't know if they shot the baby in the head, but she says that two youngsters between the ages of 10 and 15. Between the ages of 10 and 15, that's quite the range. Like, you don't know the difference between a 10-year-old and a 15-year-old? That's not an insignificant range. Yes, the clocks are actually synced. Remember, we wanted to end the audio about 10 seconds before, so we have a nice, clean end to the show. Like, we had a nice, clean beginning of the show, except for the video. Well, thank you, everybody. Thank you. I think we're done. The Pope, and the Pope is a misogynist. They had some nun on CNN saying, I scoured, and I can't find him saying anything about women. Well, why don't you look at my Facebook page, bitch? He hates women. He's a Catholic priest. He hates women. Although, well, I'm going to see. He wants a poor church and a church for the poor. He paid his own hotel bill, and he took the bus. All right. I got my eye on you, potato. I got my eye on you, Pope Jorge. Thank you for joining us today. Thank you, Byron.
This
thank you, Boca.
Is the South Florida it Radio.
The She Play coming up next. No worries. She Play coming up next. Starring Alan Michaels.